asampaye tia obayansa fusu obun he wan kana asam ze mafu tu sam ka krewa asupeme yo kofi o man ya woman o man ya mama na deni bebi akọ ta 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 ya ware ni ponsom ponsom wanini pa asa de pa wo fi oye demo embera ye ebe iya ifunana ama ya umano ama ya mama na adi waye no ra nyami ta ta nye mama renya ponsom ponsom wanini pa so wa ya
My name is Mr. Emmanuel Amankwa. I'm a senior lecturer at Food Science and Technology Department.
Personally, what is your take on the fight against corruption?
Yeah, I think so far, I think Ghana is doing well, though it is a bit slow, and it is very interesting to note here this evening that the youth is already working, you know, in that line of argument or in that aspect. And I think once the youth, the future is for the youth. If the youth take a position as far as corruption is concerned, I'm sure in the nearest future, Ghana will reduce corruption to the barest minimum. And as a country, I think we should strengthen the institutions that fight against corruption, and people who are found culpable should be punished. I think it should be done in such a way that people should be scared, should be afraid of going into corrupt practices. I mean, that culture should be there. It should be embedded in the minds of the people, so that they will not even attempt, because they know that once they do it, there is a law somewhere that will deal with them. I think that will help us.
Now, talking about punishment, we've realized that government comes, government goes. This particular government we're having has taken an initiative to establish a special prosecutor. What do you think about this particular move by this current government?
I think the current government had made some promises about fighting corruption. And you know, when it comes to corruption, you don't just say it. You have to put certain things in place that will help make your dream come true or your vision realized. And I think the special prosecutor has been given certain powers which they can work in such a way that some of the political corruption, which as it were go unpunished this time around, would be punished. Don't also forget that this time around the Auditor General will not only give its report, but now can go after those who are found in corruption, who are engaged in corruption, which is a good thing. And you see, you asked about the special prosecutor. I think this time around, it's not going to be a 9-day wonder. It's not going to be the previous government. It is the present, the past, and the future. So therefore, any person in government at the moment would be scared, you know, to even attempt to be corrupt, because if you are caught, I'm sure that independent prosecutor or the special prosecutor will deal with you by law and not by any machinations from any political party or the present government.
Now, how did you see this evidence debate, and what will be your message to Ghana Integrity Initiative, the local chapter of Transparency International?
Yeah, I think they've done a good job. GII has done a very good job and for involving the youth, because they are the future leaders. And you know, people in the, during the argument, they talked about the adults. It's like culturally affecting negatively the mindset of the youth in various homes, so that if you can tackle it from the youth end, I think it will have a positive effect on this country.
Amoredu Daniel from KNUST, Department of Fisheries and Watershed Management. I'm a proud fish farmer.
Personally, how do you see the future in terms of fighting corruption in the country?
The future is bright. Corruption can actually be uprooted in Ghana. And the youth of Ghana today are more poised now than ever in the fight against corruption. I wouldn't look further in this particular moment. Tomorrow we are about to witness in KNUST an impeachment of a college president who has actually gone overboard and actually gone beyond the constitution of the association. We believe in transparency, accountability and probity in KNUST. Students of KNUST have, on any grounds that they have suspected any form of embezzlement, corruption, nepotism, favoritism, any form of inclination towards one particular group, either in the form of a petition, in the form of a demonstration or a protest, actually vehemently gone against corruption. We have cases, numerous cases in KNUST to prove this fact. In Ghana as a whole, we can see that the youth of Ghana are fighting. Though we do not have the power, but we also believe in the legendary statement of the University Hall of KNUST that says that what we rest not, we won't faint. We would rise to the occasion. We would fight corruption with every inch of breath we have got. This is because they would go and die. The old will pass away, and we would have to inherit, one, what they left for us, whether good or bad. We want a better future for Ghana. By virtue of the education that the older generation have entrusted in us, we as the learned youth of Ghana have decided to hold hands to lead Ghana out of corruption, together with the able and good public officials in Ghana. We use this platform to applaud every public official, every individual who has stood against corruption in Ghana. You deserve the applause of every Ghanaian.
My name is Ajoa Safredo Subonti and I'm the Speaker of KNUST Student Parliament House. My belief, corruption has done a lot of harm to Ghana and the African continent as a whole. I believe the developed countries have done their best to fight it, to get to where they are now, and we all have to fight for it to stop at a point in time. And so then engaging in such debates and such programs is one way of achieving that. So I believe that yes, corruption should be fought against and it should be eradicated, if not sooner, later.
Now, looking at the current state of our political climate, how do you see the future of the fight against corruption?
I believe that yes, there are speculations and assumptions that a lot of political entities in Ghana are corrupt, but I believe that it's about the youth. We have to start from the grassroots. During the debate, I believe the minority caucus, although they lost, made a cogent point that we have to reorient the coming generation. If you are able to do that, I believe it will forestall it in the future. And then currently we can keep on sensitizing people so that they stop, they cut down on their corrupt actions, and then eventually I believe it will die down.
Personally, what do you think you can do to help fight corruption in the country?
Personally, as a person, I believe that writing write-ups and then articles is a way, but then also peer-to-peer, executive to executive, I can be able to tell them that when we are given a duty, you are supposed to carry it out, not because you want something out of it, but because you can affect your generation. Once you affect your generation, the reward just comes like that. So that is what I believe for now I would like to do.
Hey, my name is Chumesi Steven. I'm a final year student. BSC Akocha. First of all, I must congratulate those who participated in the event. Secondly, I must say that the program outliners did very well, those who organized it. It is very important that issues of national importance like this are brought to light, and then engaging students, and for that matter the youth, in trying to address these issues are very paramount. This initiative is one that I will commend, and then I would also want to pass a quick comment that it should continue. As much as we engage students and the youth on issues of corruption and how we can uproot it, we can take it off our society.
Have you ever on any day been a victim of corruption?
Honestly, day-to-day activities, one would come across such instances. Personally, I haven't come to that level where I can vividly point that this is a corruption or a corrupt act or activity. But then I understand that as I move on in life, I certainly will encounter a major issue of that sort.
Now, personally, how do you see the fight against corruption by government and the youth or individuals within the country?
There's that effort. For instance, the current government trying to work with an independent prosecutor. I think that is one plus. Then again, I think civil society today and organizations in the Transparency International, IOCO, and the other civil bodies, I mean SRAJ and all that, are doing so well. They're doing so well. And I think that going forward, the youth must be involved a lot. I understand, for instance, in KNUST, there are a lot of students today who are interested in fighting the issues of corruption. Most of the times they target the SRCs, they target the colleges, they target the departments and the faculties. And certainly this brings back the hope that our society is getting that sort of activists tomorrow who are interested and who want to get our community on track if today we are veering off. Yeah.
I'm Honorable Charles Tingan, a proud Continental VSC student and then a proud member of the Majority Caucus.
Okay, as part of the activities marking the National Anti-Corruption and Transparency Week, the Ghana Integrity Initiative local chapter of Transparency International, in collaboration with the United States Embassy and the Institute of Economic Affairs, it organized this intra-tertiary debate contest. Today happens to be the 10th of KNUST Students Parliament. How did you see the program?
It was a wonderful one, considering the fact that the both members or the two caucuses debated intellectually, and then we got to know that indeed, yes, the youth is actually doing something, and then we can do something about corruption without regard to our social political situation in the country at the moment. It was very fruitful. Indeed, at the moment, we are doing something. We are talking. He cited an example. We are saying that the pen is always mightier than the sword, and that's very true. We are indeed doing something, and then I believe, yes, we can do more.
As a person, what can you do to support the fight against corruption?
As an individual, yes. The only thing would probably do to champion this cause is to air out our views and always try as much as possible as leaders to represent our students very well wherever we go, and then to also make sure we ourselves live lives worthy of nation, lives without corruption, and I believe we'll go far.
those of us who came in here, we are going to spread the news to the other colleagues and others. Since they won the debate, that the youth can also contribute. I believe that we all have a shared responsibility. Because
so as an individual, what will be your take on the fight against corruption? What can you do to help against the fight that we are all fighting to prevent corruption from our country?
Oh, I've already started. I've come up with an organization called Concern and Patriotic Future Leaders. CAPFO, we are the future leaders in the country. So we have a role to play. That is why I've come up with this organization, mobilize my colleague youth on campus to do everything possible within our power to join the fight.
Okay. My name is Asamoah Ismail-Hambela, and I'm from Kane West.
Today you happen to be a part of this particular intra-tertiary debate organized by Ghana Integrity Initiative, the local chapter of Transparency International, in collaboration with Institute of Economic Affairs, Ghana. How did you see this particular debate organization?
Oh, this debate was educative. Like, we got an opportunity to be informed about corruption from both the majority and the minority side. It was very excruciating. We are very glad we came today. We got something in our brains.
Personally, how do you see the fight against corruption and your part to play?
The fight against corruption is a very big fight that we shouldn't play with it. Currently, Ghana's fight against corruption is a bit dire, because I see that corruption currently is a misdemeanor, and then it's a minor crime. So for we to fight corruption, we have to update corruption to a felony, so that it will bring that fear. People are going to fear doing corruption. Like, you go to countries like China, corruption is a felony. It's something you don't mention your name about. You don't have to mention it. It is very difficult for you to engage, because you are afraid of the punitive actions that you may inculcate into yourself. So corruption, for you to fight it, you have to start bringing it from a misdemeanor to a felony. So with that one, we can fight corruption.
I'm Mahmoud Kabore, student here, geography student, and minor in politics, also from the majority caucus. It has been a fruitful deliberation. It has kind of arose our potentials of fighting corruption. It has drawn our attention. It has bring back our minds on what to do as youths in the country to fight against corruption.
What will be your message to Ghana Integrity Initiative, the local chapter of Transparency International?
Kudos to GII, IEA, and the various groups that is fighting against corruption. I think it's a good, and what my advice is that we should spread our tentacles, and normally it involves a lot of money, and I would advise other social bodies and other groups who have the resources to come in and then support this venture, because that is the way forward. If the youth delinks itself from corruption, I'm sure the country will have a better future. Yeah.
We pray that this fight from Ghana Integrity will be supported by even more international donors. We thank U.S. Embassy for helping out in this particular course. We thank the IEA for helping out in this particular course. We owe you much as the youth of Ghana for what you are entrusting in our care. We are pledging today that we will not relent on our efforts in the fight against corruption, no matter what happens, because some people shed their blood for Ghana to be Ghana today. If we cannot stand in their shoes, then we are not worthy to even be called citizens of Ghana. Onward, Christian soldiers, but we will say, arise, Ghana youth, for your country. Thank you very much, GII, for this platform. And we hope to see that GII, that Ghana Integrity Initiative. From here, I am going to write on your website, I paid a bribe. This time around, I'll write, he didn't take any bribe. He is good. Thank you very much.
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to thank the mother body for having the vision to set up such an organization, and for extending it to Ghana, for us to have the Ghana Integrity Initiative. They are doing a great job, and I'm very glad that they extended the invitation to us and we partnered with them. We pray that from year to year, and even from month to month, and even from chapters to chapters in the year, they'll be able to organize such programs in order to increase the awareness for us to fight against corruption.
Powerful, powerful, powerful. Honestly, I enjoyed the event in that if students are brought together, sensitized on the issue of corruption with a national interest, which is very sensitive, then any movement, any organization who attempts this must be commended and must be given a place in our society. For the fact that Africa in general suffers from a canker like this, when we all know Africa is a poor continent, when you have a community, a society, an organization like Ghana Integrity Initiative, you should laud them. They should be given a place in our society. They should be protected. If we can, we should even fund their activities and promote them and their activities so that we can get rid of corruption in our societies and get our youth involved in issues of national interest, which is corruption. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, we appreciate them very much, and then we would urge them to continue with the good works they've started, and we believe corruption with their help, and then without help also corruption would be extinct from country. Thank you very much.
They have done a fantastic job. I think if other civil society organizations emulate such a move, it will go a long way. Going to all these tertiary institutions to come out with this initiative, what I'm trying to say is that they should keep it up, because it's going to help. Already it has helped. It has actually defined some kind of understanding about how corruption in the country. I will give them 100% for such an effort.
Well, I think my message to them is that they should keep on, they should extend this program to the SHS, JHS, so that the junior brothers and that they could also get the opportunity to learn and then know more about corruption. Because from that place, if they have the knowledge about corruption, they can start it from there and they can boot corruption out of our system.
GII and IEA, I would say a very big thank you to them. This is one of the massive programs that we can think of, because a nation with corruption can never progress. But one thing I would like to say again is GII should extend their wings, because as in the local dialect, Agrobe, the kids at the GHS, the kids at the senior high schools are those coming to join the youth in no time. So I think it will be very good and very sensitive to think of it that they should also establish this, or they should stress their wings to the junior high and the senior high, so that they will also be enlightened on the fact that they have a role to play in fighting against corruption in the country.
My name is Jacob Tete Ahuno. I'm the Programs Officer for Ghana Integrity Initiative.
Then we know that as part of the activities commemorating the National Anti-Corruption and Transparency Week, you were able to bring up this particular intra-tertiary debate where you had support from IEA Ghana and then United States Embassy. What really motivated Ghana Integrity Initiative to bring up this particular cause?
Yes, Ghana Integrity Initiative really believes, as part of other anti-corruption partners, believe that the fight against corruption is multifaceted. And so we don't have to just limit it to one organization, be it public, private, or civil society, but we all need to come together. And that's why the need for today's, this year's National Anti-Corruption Week celebrations theme, which is NACAP, the National Anti-Corruption Plan. It's mainly strengthening private, public, and civil society partnership in the fight against corruption. So it brings about everybody. And as we know, if everybody is supposed to come on board, then in terms of the various age groupings, which is adults, the youth, and the children, so all these levels need to be also brought on board. And so we picked a unique spot, because as we speak, as part of the week, GII again with SHRAJ, which is the National Anti-Corruption Organization that is leading the fight against corruption, is in partnership, and they are doing what we call the integrity clubs, that is for the junior and senior high schools. And as we speak, on the 10th of December, we'll be doing What Do You Know with the children. And so that's another angle. And then we realize that we've taken care of the children. Now let's come to the youth. And at the youth level, we believe our university institutions do have the capacity where the youth intellect are being built. out. And so therefore we need to bring them on board the discussion on the way we fight corruption in this nation. And that's how come the idea of the intra-tertiary debate came up. So we said, fine, we believe there are ideas in our universities which has not been tapped. And so when we give this platform to them, ideas will be shared, and these ideas will culminate into issues that the policymakers can pick and run with, and then we can be able together to reduce corruption in our dear nation.
How did you see today's program here at KNUST Students Parliament?
Very, very interesting. Very, very interesting. In fact, there were one unique aspect that came up that I was so happy about was the mention of the I Paid a Bribe platform for the Bangladesh. And I feel that is something that we have seen, that there is a slight gap with the knowledge, because Ghana Integrity Initiative has created what we call the www.ipaidabribe.org.gh internet platform, where citizens can report their experience of bribery, be it they were forced to pay, be it they paid it willingly, be it they resisted paying, and be it that they met an honest official who did not demand bribe from them. So this is something that during the debate, when it was mentioned, I realized, oh, that this is an opportunity to lay the foundation for students to take on board the platform and make use of it. Again, some of the issues that were discussed, especially for me, looking at the argument from the majority side, the debaters brought up issues considering that youth activism is ongoing on campuses. And this is something that we can all see happening, especially here in KNUST. And so I believe that they are earnesting the ideas of everybody gathered there to see that it is a need for us to come on board the anti-corruption fight. Again, on the minority side, the argument that when corrupt officials are caught and maybe the case comes up, we don't see any resolution to those cases, be it persecution or punishment or even sanctions. We don't see anything. And so it does not encourage others to also report corruption, because if they do what has been reported, they don't see any outcome. How then do they come out and also report? So those are issues that I believe policymakers can pick up and say, okay, because people are reporting and sanctions are not coming up, that means people are being apathetic about reporting. And so therefore we need to make sure that the cases that are currently ongoing should come to a conclusion that will mean justice has prevailed. And if that happens, others will be encouraged to come on board. As well as, again, what is happening currently, I even believe that some of the policies that are currently running, like the National Youth Employment, it is an opportunity for youth to demonstrate their integrity in the work, in the field of work. Because hitherto we are looking at schools, people are students, and so maybe they have not been exposed to money as much as those in the working environment. And so if youth are being engaged in the National Youth Employment, then we are expecting that that's the platform for them to also demonstrate to the adults that they have the ability to be people with integrity. So those who are even in the system can also be integrity, people with integrity.
We know that you are targeting the youth, and most of our youth are today found on most of the social media platforms. How are you sensitizing the youth with the use of the media?
Great, thank you very much. As I mentioned, one of the platforms is that I Paid a Bribe. The ALAC is the toll-free platform which makes use of using the telephone. It's also another means of communication. Now, GII has the Facebook platform. We also have our Twitter platform. Facebook is Ghana Integrity Initiative. If you go there, you can like our page, and whatever issues come up, we post it there. Especially even the I Paid a Bribe, we serialize it. The issues that people report on I Paid a Bribe, we put them on Facebook for people to see and then know what is happening. Again, when you go to our Twitter page, we then discuss some of this issue, because at initially Twitter was limited in terms of typing and writing space. So we tend to summarize everything and create a link to our website, which will give you more detailed information. So you can also like our Twitter page, which is Ghana Integrity, and then you can be able to join us. You can also go to TI Ghana to also like our page. We also have a YouTube account where we share videos, and including what we have done today will be posted on our YouTube page. And the YouTube page is Ghana Integrity. Ghana Integrity. If you go to YouTube and type Ghana Integrity, you will have access to our YouTube page, where you can have videos of events that we have undertaken that are all coming together to reduce corruption in our dear nation.
From here, KNUST, when is it?
We are going to the University of Cape Coast. That will take place on the 9th of December. That is a Saturday. And there's also going to be another massive debate that is going to go on there. But that is not even the end. As I told you, we are in partnership with the IEA in this debate, and it's ongoing in 4 university campuses. We have done KNUST. We are also going to move to UDS, that is the University of Development Studies, Tamale Campus, and then we are also going to do the almighty Ghana National University, which we know as the University of Ghana, Legon. So that is another place that we are also going to do the and debate.
Okay. Finally, how do you see the fight against corruption with government and as individuals?
With government, I would say there have been a lot of lip services in terms of the current government's campaign promises. Everybody believed that this very election was on the edge of going to either the incumbent or the opposition based on corruption cases. And so I believe that the president has mentioned a lot about what is happening in terms of corruption and what he wants to do to fight corruption. Now, he has said don't solve the problem. The issue is action. And now we believe that this is the time for him to demonstrate all the things he said during the campaign period. This is the time for him, as he has the power, to act on the issues. We are happy, for example, that the passage of the special prosecutor's bill is in force. But there's a big question. The special prosecutor will need information to work. Where is he going to get it? Citizens will need information to be able to report, to blow the whistle on corrupt officials. And all these things will come to pass if the right to information bill is what? Passed. And that is something that for the past 10 years has been lying on the tables of the parliament. And we believe that with all the talk about fight against corruption, the president will encourage, especially the majority in parliament, to push the agenda of passing the RTI. Again, the code of conduct for public officers. If you don't know what is right and wrong, how would you judge the actions of a public official? And that is why the code of conduct is also another important bill that has to be passed. Finally, the asset declaration, which falls within the code of conduct, but the whistleblower amendment bill is also another, because we want to encourage people to blow the whistle. Now, the protection and other aspect of it has to be firmed so that people will be encouraged to report, because they know they will not be victimized. And so those are the things that I believe that if the president, the government aspects in fighting corruption need to be put in place for us to say, yes, indeed, Ghana is taking a bold step in the fight against corruption. Individual-wise, I would say, unless people view corruption as something that not just affects them, but even people around them. Today, as we speak, if we move to the hospitals, you would find somebody you know. Any of the major hospitals, you might have a link to somebody who is lying on the bed. So if there's corrupt in the health system, that person will suffer. It means some part of you are. So that's if you are not affected directly. And again, as I mentioned, if you take education, as we are on campus, if you take education serious, and we don't also add the aspect of fighting corruption, the education will come to nothing. Because whatever you have, you need to pay your way to get a job, because the officials are corrupt. So we need to fight corruption alongside, as we learn, we need to also put in place measures to also reduce corruption in our dear nation. Thank you.
Ghana Integrity Initiative, local chapter of Transparency International. We're very grateful for you bringing this particular program here at KNUST. We hope to see you at UCC. Yamoye mbira ye ebe ya ifri enara.